What if I told you that in June 2025, humanity unlocked secrets that could rewrite our past, reshape our future, and even redefine what it means to be alive? These aren't just discoveries. They're doorways to worlds we never imagined. From the moon's silent whispers to the red dust of Mars, from ancient books bound in secrets to a cosmic visitor brushing past Earth, this is the story of 10 breakthroughs that will grip your soul and shake your reality. Buckle up, you're not ready for this. Picture this, February 2025. A robotic lander, Odysseus, touches down on the moon's desolate surface. But at the last second, it stumbles, tilting 30 degrees, clinging to the lunar soil like a wounded explorer. Mission control holds its breath. Failure? Not quite. Strapped to this craft is Rolls 1, NASA's first ever radio telescope on the moon. And it's about to hear something extraordinary. This telescope, with its four spring-loaded arms, wasn't just listening to the stars, it caught Earth's voice, twinkling through the atmosphere like a cosmic campfire. For the first time, we heard our planet from 384,000 kilometers away. But here's the kicker, that twinkling, it's a clue, a hint that alien signals, if they exist, might shimmer the same way through distant atmospheres. In just a few hours, before its power died, Rolls 1 opened a window to the search for extraterrestrial life. Imagine it, the moon, our quiet neighbor, just became humanity's ear to the universe. But what if the answers aren't out there, but right here, on a planet we thought we knew? Mars, the red planet. Its crimson hue has haunted our imaginations for centuries. We thought we knew why. Hematite, an iron oxide born in dry, desolate conditions. But in June 2025, scientists flipped the script. The real culprit? Ferrihydrite, an iron oxide forged in wet conditions. Proof that Mars wasn't always the barren wasteland we see today. 3 billion years ago, during Mars's Hesperian era, volcanoes roared, ice melted, and rivers flowed. Ferrihydrite painted the planet red as water shaped its surface. This discovery isn't just about color, it's a whisper of a Mars that once teemed with possibility. Could there have been life? Were microbes swimming in those ancient waters? Every grain of red dust is now a question, begging us to dig deeper. And speaking of digging into the past, thoughtful. France, 12th century. Monks in Clairvaux Abbey craft books that will outlive empires. But in June 2025, a team of researchers uncovered something astonishing about these medieval tomes. Surprised? Their bindings? Not cowhide, not goat skin, seal skin. From harbors in Scandinavia, Iceland, maybe even Greenland. DNA tests revealed a trade network vaster than we ever imagined. These seals weren't local. They swam in waters thousands of miles from France. This discovery rewrites the medieval world, showing us a web of commerce stretching across oceans, connecting Vikings, monks, and maybe even Inuit kayakers spotted off Scotland's coast centuries later. Each book is a map, a story of humanity's relentless drive to explore, trade, and connect. Thoughtful. What other secrets are hidden in the pages of history? But what about the humans who wrote those stories? What did they face? 41,000 years ago, Earth was under siege. A geomagnetic event, the Lachamp excursion, weakened our planet's magnetic shield, letting ultraviolet rays pour through. Neanderthals struggled. Some say it helped drive them to extinction. But Homo sapiens? We adapted. How? With sunscreen. Red ochre, painted across bodies, wasn't just decoration, it was survival, a shield against the sun's wrath. This discovery forces us to rethink our ancestors. Were they more ingenious than we gave them credit for? And the Neanderthals, were they really so different? Every stroke of ochre is a testament to human resilience, a reminder that even in the face of cosmic chaos, we find a way. But resilience isn't just about surviving the sun. It's about defying the cosmos itself. Uranus is a planet of secrets. Tilted on its side, its magnetic field a chaotic mess, it's defied our understanding for decades. In 1986, Voyager 2 gave us a fleeting glimpse, pegging its day at 17 hours, 14 minutes, and 24 seconds. But we were wrong by 28 seconds. In June 2025, using auroras and magnetic data, scientists nailed down Uranus's true rhythm with 1,000 times more precision. This isn't just a number, it's a key to unlocking the mysteries of a planet that challenges everything we know about our solar system. What else is Uranus hiding, and what does it mean for the worlds beyond? Speaking of worlds beyond, what about the one we thought we knew? For years, we thought dinosaurs were on their last legs before that fateful asteroid struck 66 million years ago. Fossils seemed to dwindle, suggesting a slow decline. But in June 2025, a team at University College London turned that idea upside down. Analyzing 8,000 fossils, they found the drop wasn't extinction, it was geology. The rocks simply stopped preserving dinosaurs as well. New species were still emerging, just slower than before. This discovery forces us to rethink the dinosaurs' final days. Were they thriving, not fading? And if so, what does that say about the fragility of life itself? But survival isn't just about the past, it's about the future. The moon is humanity's next frontier. But how do you power a base on a world with no air, no fuel, no mercy? In June 2025, a team in Germany found the answer: moon glass. By melting lunar regolith with a crystal called perovskite, they created solar cells right on the moon's surface. At 12% efficiency, these cells are a game changer. No need to ship heavy panels from Earth, just a kilogram of perovskite for 400 square meters of power. This isn't just about the moon, Mars, asteroids, even Mercury. Anywhere with sunlight and silicate rocks could become humanity's next home. The stars are closer than you think. But what about life itself? How did it begin? 498 million years ago, the Cambrian period was a crucible of life. But fossils from Canada, untouched since the 1990s, revealed something astonishing. Early animals, worms, slug-like creatures, could survive out of water, if only for a moment. These fossils, found in dried-out mud, show life was already testing the boundaries of the ocean. This wasn't just survival, it was evolution's first dare. 500 million years ago, life was already dreaming of land. What else was it dreaming of?
And what if we could dream like that, inside our own minds? What if we could rewrite the way we think?
In June 2025, scientists did just that. Not in humans, but in mice. By swapping chemical synapses for electrical ones using fish proteins, they changed how a mouse's brain worked. The result? A calmer, more sociable creature. This isn't just about mice. It's a glimpse into a future where we could treat anxiety, depression, or OCD by rewiring the brain itself. But here's the shadow. What happens when we can control thoughts? When technology can reshape who we are, this discovery is a Pandora's box, hope and danger in equal measure.
And finally,
a visitor from the stars. On April 13, 2029, an asteroid named Apophis will brush past Earth, closer than our own satellites. Once feared as a potential destroyer, it's now our greatest opportunity. NASA, ESA, and JAXA are racing to meet it, with missions like the repurposed OSIRIS-REx ready to study its secrets. This 450-meter rock isn't just a curiosity, it's a blueprint. By studying its structure, we'll learn how to deflect future threats. As Earth's gravity tugs at Apophis, seismic ripples will reveal its core. This is more than science, it's survival. A chance to protect our world from the cosmos's next roll of the dice. These 10 discoveries aren't just facts, they're stories of a moon that listens, a planet that remembers, and a species that dares to dream beyond the stars. They remind us that every answer we find only leads to more questions. What's next? What will July 2025 bring? The universe is calling. Will you answer?